This video is about fundamental information about HVAC. Here, let's understand what's basic awareness and fundamentals of HVAC. What is it HVAC stands for? That is a heating, ventilating, and air conditioning system. So, what is the meaning of heating and ventilating air conditioning system? It's very simple. It is a process of removing the heat from one place and rejecting it outside atmosphere. This is heating, venting, and creating air conditioning system. After rejecting the heat, it creates air conditioning. Air conditioning in the sense, so circulating fresh air, filtered air, and temperature and moisture controlled. Moisture in the sense of humidity. So it creates a human comfort. Human comfort in the sense, so if you maintain and particular that machine with this air conditioning system, which supplies the fresh filtered air with temperature and humidity controlled to its required temperature and required humidity. This is called as a comfort zone, human comfortable. So this system, entire system is called as heating and ventilating air conditioning system. By removing the heat from particular one place and rejecting it to the atmosphere and circulating some fresh filtered air, the contaminations. So that is particulate matters, you can say that. By filtering particulate matters and by controlling temperature and humidity, that is the moisture, so within the required ranges. So that creates human comfortability so that you can enjoy the air conditioning system. This is not so easy, as I said, explained like this. It requires so many missions, and the functions of each and every missions, of course, matters. But naturally, it happens outside without all these missions, that particularly in particular one seasons, that is in December, in the month of November, January, and December also. You see that you feel cold outside, it naturally happens outside. That we are going to create this human comfortness and controlling this air conditions, conditioning the air by using machines artificially. That is what all this heating, ventilating, air conditioning system tells about. See that, as I said, you should circulate a fresh air, and temperature and humidity should be controlled. The temperature should be within that 22 to 25 degrees centigrade. And the moisture, as you said, technically that is the humidity, it should be controlled. It should be within that 40 to 60 RH relative humidity. And of course, filtering that contaminations, the dust particles, that is particulate matters in the air. So then how to create human comfort circulating this type of air, that is what it tells about. Before explaining this fundamentals, before understanding the fundamentals, let us understand the basic information about. As I said, the moisture, it is nothing but the humidity that water contains. As you know that we have air has a moisture, that is a humidity. And similarly, in our human body also, we have air and moisture, that is nothing but our sweat. When the sweat comes out from our body, it has to get evaporated into the atmosphere. It is a natural phenomenon. It has to. This is a human comfort, but that is a cooling system. It depends on the perception, human perception, your feeling. That the air conditioning system, air cooling is how fast your moisture from your body gets evaporated to atmosphere, so fast you feel cool. This naturally happens. But sometimes when the air has maximum moisture in it, more than our body, the moment is sweat, that air, that atmosphere, that never gets, it takes this moisture which comes out from your body. You mean that sweat never gets evaporated, you feel hot. This is one condition. In the second condition, if the air, moisture in the air, the humidity in the air is less than our body. The moment you sweat, the sweat from your body gets evaporated rapidly, fast, as that air sucks it rapidly. So then you feel cold. This is what naturally happens. So we are going to create this effect throughout the air by using these emissions, by using this HVAC system. And the HVAC system cycle diagram, this is before going to this explanation, I was telling about the humidity, water contents. The water is integral part of our life. Every day, every time we are using, every day we are depending on it. This water is available, made available in three status. That is in solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. This is a basic information about this. So if you understand this concept, you will understand this HVAC concept also. When the water reaches solid state, normally we call it ice. When it reaches a liquid state, we call it as water. When it reaches gaseous state, we call it as a mist, moisture, or humidity, gaseous state. Just you take a piece of a solid, what is that, ice cube in a small container and heat it. Add heat to that ice cube. Then you can see that this ice starts melting, it becomes liquid. See, by adding heat to the solid, it changes the state into liquid. Again, further, keep adding heat to this liquid, it starts boiling and it starts evaporating. So that by heating this liquid, further it changes the status from liquid to the gaseous stage. Then that changes the ultimate stage. Again, further you cannot heat it, you cannot increase the temperature, you cannot heat it further. Instead of heating that, if you reduce the temperature, if you cool it, remove the temperature, remove the heat from the gas, you see that reverse process takes place. It converts into liquid. It goes back to the liquid state. Again, remove heat from this liquid. Again, it goes back to the solid state. It's just this. It's a science, actually. You need not to go to any R&D center to check this. You can check it at your rooms, at your houses also. It clearly shows that by adding heat and removing the heat from this, it changes from solid to liquid and liquid to gas, again gas to liquid and liquid to solid. This process has been adapted. The entire HVAC system works on this principle, on this logic only. But there, instead of using this water, we are going to use gas. By using that gas, by heating and removing the heat, by adding the heat and by removing the heat to this, that gas rapidly changes for different stages, that is liquid stage and gaseous stage. By changing this liquid to gas or gas to liquid somewhere in particular one particular phase, so it creates a cooling effect. This is what this, this is the main concept of the air conditioning system. And this is not so as simple as I explained. It involves, I told you, it involves so many machines. It requires four machines, important main machines, main devices. So this is, I will show this concept. I will show this individual machines, how they are connected and working principle of each and every machine in the HVAC cycle diagram. Each and every machine is, each and every device is very important. It has this four important machines, that is a compressor, condenser, expansion valve, and evaporator. Again, all these four machines, again though all those four machines are internally connected to each other, interconnected to each other by copper pipes. And I told you the gas we are using in this, which is creating this cooling effect, that normally different gases are being used in this field. R12, R22, R134, R400 series, R500 series, like this. As you know that R22 has been banned from 2010, the stop of the manufacturing of this gas itself because of some issues. That is, World Health Organization conducted survey and found that this gas is damaging the environment that is damaging the ozone layer. It is polluting the air. Because of this, the temperature is increasing, and because of this, the global warming, you might have heard about that. This is a result of this. So that is why, to avoid this one, they completely banned the manufacturing of this. In place of R22, now R134A is being used. And you come to that air condition types of air conditioning system. You might have heard about this, so package AC, window AC, cassette AC, PAC, precision AC, and centralized AC, duct AC, and the chiller. Whatever it may be, the type, irrespective of the types of this, different types, in all these makes, these four components are there. It is must. These four devices, that is compressor, condenser, expansion, and evaporator, must be there. Now let us see this, how these four components will function, and what is the contribution of each and every machine or device creating cooling effect. So first, the compressor. See, the compressor, function of the compressor, once before starting these devices, I told you about the gas R134A, that should be filled in that compressor. That the filling process is called as a charging. After charging the gas, if you start this compressor, the compressor compresses this gas and it increases the pressure. The purpose of increasing the pressure is to, it has to move from this way to the next stage, that is to condenser. So in order to move this condenser, the pressure should be increased. The pressure is increased. This high pressure gas, once the pressure is increased, whether it is a liquid or gas, sorry, solid or liquid or gases, once the pressure of this increases, automatically the temperature will increase, the heat is produced. Here the function of the purpose of compressing this is not to produce the heat, not to heat the gas. It is a natural phenomena. When you compress this solid or liquid or gases, natural heat is produced. Similarly here also, once the pressure increased, of course temperature is also increased, it hot high pressure gas, it goes to condenser. In this condenser, with the help of this small fan, cooling fan, this switch on this fan, that cools this, that remove the heat from this gas. I told you, here the pressure and the temperature increase. When this high pressure hot gas is circulating through this condenser, because of this fan, they switch on, the heat is exchanged here. It is removing the heat. It is creating cooling effect. It is removing the heat from this gas. When the heat is removed from the gas, you know that the previous example I given, if you remove the heat from the gas, naturally it goes back to this previous state, that becomes a liquid. Similarly here also, it becomes a liquefied gas. The status changes. This liquefied gas, the pressure is remain same. High pressure liquefied gas goes to the next state, that is expansion valve. The function of expansion valve is to reduce the pressure of the gas, reduce the pressure, to control the pressure. It will reduce the pressure of this gas. Here, once the pressure is reduced, this low pressure liquefied gas, which goes to the next stage, that is evaporator. This is very, very important here. When this is a low pressure liquefied gas is circulating through the small thin pipes in this evaporator, which absorbs the heat from the surrounding places in the air, and it creates a cooling effect. You see that when it is absorbing the heat, it is nothing but the heat is adding to this liquid low pressure gas. As I said, when you add heat to the liquid, again it becomes gas. Similarly here also, by absorbing the heat from the surrounding places, that is nothing but by adding heat to this, it's converted and again it changes into the gaseous stage. And of course it is creating cooling effect here, and again it is changed to the gaseous stage. That gas, again it enters to the compressor. It's the same process takes place. Here the pressure is increased, temperature is increased, here it is cooled down, and because of that removing the heat from the gas, it is changed into liquid stage. High pressure liquefied gas enters the expansion. Here the pressure is reduced, low pressure liquefied gas entered the evaporator, which absorbs the heat from the surrounding places, and it is creating cooling effect at the same time. After absorbing the heat, it is nothing but adding heat to the gas liquid. Again, it is converted into the gas and it enters. This phenomena, this process continuously takes place as long as all these devices are working, switched on. Similarly, continuously the gas is circulating, it changes, it is changing from one state, that is liquid state to gas state and gas to liquid, and here continuous cooling effect is being created. This cold air can be circulated inside wherever you want, in a room or hall, wherever, by using a fan. So this is the working principle of this air conditioning, basic fundamental working principle of this air conditioning system. Whether it is a different type, whether it is a package AC or split AC or a chiller or whatever PAC, whatever it may be, the working, all these four elements will be there, and the working principle of each and every element machine is same. And here in this, the description what I explained so far, that is also clearly mentioned here. And next, I told you about these gases. Usually we say that R22 and R134, even R12 also, R12 gas, it is being used in the refrigerator. And R22, it used to use in air conditioning system in chillers and all. Of course, it's been banned. In place of that, they're using this R134. Yeah? And there is a technical name of this. This technical name is it CFC gases, that is CFC in the chlorofluorocarbon. It's usually called as R12, R11, R12, and R502. Again, R22 and R400, say that is R401A, R123, this is HCFC gas. A combination of hydrogen, chlorine, and carbon. And again, HFC gas. This is what I told you, 134A. This is a familiar gas being used in most of the places. This is the combination of hydrogen, chlorine, and carbon. The combination of these gases. In general, these are called as represented by R22, R12, R134, like this. That is refrigerant. Okay. And the next, the types of AC. As I said, I shown there are different types of ACs. That is window AC, package AC, and a cassette AC. All these three belongs to one family, one group. Normally, these are called as portable ACs or package ACs. In this, if you open this, you can see all these four elements, machines are packed inside. So it's called package AC. Again, it's split AC. When you open this split AC air conditioning system, you cannot see these four elements in particular one place. These are split into two different layers. That is the important part, which is creating cooling effect that comes inside the building, indoor, and the remaining compressor, condenser, and expansion comes outside the building. That is outdoor air. This is called a split AC. And again, PAC, precision AC, this is very, very important. It is being used in server room, data center, and hub room. I will tell you about this in detail in the next video clip. And again, that next one is, there's a centralized AC or duct AC or chiller. All these three machines belongs to one group. Generally, these are called as a centralized AC. If you see the centralized AC, not as it has all the four elements, compressor, condenser, expansional, and evaporator, but not even a single machine comes inside the building. All the four machines comes outside, that is on the terrace of the building. So from there, it controls the air. It's creating cooling effect on the entire building, irrespective of number of floors. Those these are called centralized AC. And the purpose of calling the meaning of this duct AC, the cold air which is being circulated inside the building through metal duct. So it is called generally duct AC also. And the reason for calling this is a chiller. In the central AC, before creating this cold air, the chilled water is very, very important. The part which is creating chilled water, that is the main heart of this machine. So it's called generally chiller. So the chiller and centralized and the duct AC, all this belongs to one category. That is centralized. Generally, it's called centralized AC. Here in centralized air, see, one more very, very important part, additional part, that is AHU, air handling unit. Earlier, you seen that previous the cycle diagram. This is the evaporator. Here, this liquefied gas, low pressure liquefied gas, absorb the heat from the surrounding places in the air, and it creates cooling effect. It's cooled. It reduces the temperature of the air. That is how we feel cold. We can enjoy that cold air. But in chiller, this evaporator, complete this evaporator, is immersed inside water. There is a metal tank which is filled with water. Inside this gas, that is low pressure liquefied gas, is being circulated through pipes. In no way this gas and water is mixed. Now, since this evaporator which is carrying low pressure liquefied gas is immersed inside the water, now it is absorbing the heat from the water and it is cooling the water. This cools the water to the such an extent the temperature of that water, it goes to below 9 degrees centigrade. Any water which reaches below 9 degrees centigrade, normally it is called as a chilled water. So this is very, very important. That is the reason the entire machine is called as a chiller. Again, after reducing the temperature of this water, the water reaches below 10 degree centigrade, this water will be circulated through pipes and directly it enters AHU, that is air handling unit. These air handling units are installed in each and every floor. It comes inside the building. Indoor type. This is chilled water from the chiller which is mounted on the top of the building. It is circulated through the pipes and directly it goes to AH, air handling unit, which is installed inside the building. And this chilled water, when it is circulating through these pipes inside the AHU, and there is a blower in the AHU, which is the main part of this AHU. When this is switched on, the blower is switched on, it just sucks the normal air from outside with force. And this forced air, which is sucked by the blower, which sweeps over the pipes which is carrying chilled water. And naturally, there the heat is exchanged. The chilled water absorbs the heat from the air and air gets cooled and water gets heated up. This water, hot water, again it will go back to the chiller. This is how this gas is circulating inside. Similarly, the water is circulating outside from chiller to AHU, again from AHU to the chiller. Again, the hot water which goes back to the chiller, it gets cooled, again it will come back to the AHU. And the heat is exchanged, it's removed, it's absorbed the heat from the natural air, which is sucked by the blower, and the air gets cooled. This cold air directly goes inside the building through metal duct. This is how it handles the air. That is why this device is called as air handling unit. And I will tell you about this air handling unit separately. Because what are the explanation, what are the things I am explaining, all these devices which are mounted outside. When it comes to the floor maintenance, that I will explain in detail about that AHU and some other very, very important parameters, that is devices, names, about that VAV, VFD and actuator, dampers, everything comes there. I will explain in detail in the next. And then, apart from this AHU, there are some other devices in chillers, that is secondary and the primary pump and makeup tank. I told you this chilling unit consists a small tank which is filled with the water. Inside that liquid, low pressure liquefied gas will circulate in pipe. We cannot see the level of the water inside this evaporator tank. It is not transferred. It is a metal tank. In case the level of the water goes down in this chilling unit, that temperature, the cooling effect will not be created, even if you reduce the temperature also. So there will be no cooling effect. And the particular AC technicians, AC that the department receive maximum complaints, AC related complaints from the employees. To avoid this, chiller water tank is supplied with a makeup tank. It is like a over a tank which is fixed, it is mounted on the terrace of the building, and directly it is connected to this chilling unit, chiller tank. Again, the makeup tank is connected to a sump, and the AC technician has to maintain the water in the particular level of the water in the sump as well as the level of the water in that makeup tank, and automatically at the level of the water will be maintained in chilling water also, that is chilling unit also. This is about makeup tank. And the secondary and primary pumps. As I said, the entire this chiller, all these four ports, compressor, condenser, compressor, expansion, all everything is mounted on the terrace of the building. This chilled water comes down from the terrace to each and every building. Because of this gravitational force, the water circulates so easily downwards. It flows easily downwards, but a still little pressure is required. To create the pressure, the ergon pump is used, that is called a secondary pump. Again, from all these force, water has to go back to that chiller against the gravitational force. It has to go back to that terrace of the building against the gravitational force. As much pressure is required, here one more pump is required to create this pressure. That pump is called as a primary pump. So these two pumps must be always in working condition to create this cooling effect, which circulates this water from chilling unit to AHU, from AHU to pressing unit. And then, of course, this is star delta starter is very much required to switch on and switch off to control this blower. Yeah, the blower is a very, very important part of this AHU. This blower, fan of this blower is connected to the very high capacity three-phase induction motor. That is a minimum 7.5 HP capacity. Imagine when the three-phase induction motor capacity of 7.5, minimum 7.5 HP, when it is switched on, it runs at the speed of 1500 RPM. Imagine the force of that wire which sucks from outside. So powerful, that's why it's called as a blower. It is not a fan, blower. It sucks the air in such a high pressure so that if you open the door of the AHU, it will suck you also inside. Such a high pressure will be there. That is the reason you should not supposed to open the door of the AHU when it is in running condition. Even if you try also, there is automatic door limit switch which will disconnect the motor immediately the moment you open the door. As far as safety is concerned, it is very much required. And all these things I will explain in detail when it comes to the floor maintenance. And the switching on and off chillers, this is very, very important. There is a processor, standard operating processor for switch on and switch off. It is not, you cannot switch on and switch off just like any electrical other gadgets like lamps and motors. There is a standard operating processor. Normally for AC technicians, and the multi-skill technicians who are taking care of electrical as well as the air conditioning system, they should know about this. While switching on, what is the procedure? While switching on, first you have to check the and ensure enough water is stored in the sump, which is supplying water to the makeup tank. If there is no enough water, there is no water as per the requirement, you have to get it filled. That is your responsibility. Then if it is sufficient water inside the sump, then you check the valves which is from sump to liquid, what is it, makeup tank. So the valves will be there. These valves, ensure these valves are opened or not. Opened all these valves and switch on the pump. If you switch on the pump, this water gets supplied from sump to makeup tank. Again, automatically from makeup tank to it goes to chiller, automatically it maintains. You need not to worry about that. This is the first process. And the second next, once you enter, this is what you have to look after outside the building. When you go inside, you have to switch on this AHU first. You know, completely this is a suffocated area, there is no proper air circulation. You don't have that facility inside, completely sealed building it is. Forget about the cold air, at least you have to get fresh air to work inside, generally in the initial stage. Switch on this AHU, let fresh air come inside. Then switch on this primary and the secondary pump. Without switching on this primary and secondary pump, don't try to switch on chiller directly. Even if you try also, it gets trips. It trips immediately. When you switch on primary and secondary pump, this pump, these two pumps circulate the stagnated water which is filled inside the pipe from chiller to AHU, from AHU to chiller. This is very much required. When this water started circulating, then you switch on the AHU, then set the temperature. Then it will work. This is the process of switching off. And the switching off process, while switching off, first you have to switch off chiller. Then let this primary and secondary pump let run for half an hour, because the chilled water which is reached below 9 degrees centigrade, that will be circulated, that is enough to maintain this cooling effect for half an hour or 45 minutes. That is enough. Then after completing your all the work, regular rotate, what is that, daily works related to O&M, after updating all the records and all these things, then switch off this primary and secondary pump. Then come out, then switch off this sump water, which is supplying water from sump to chilling, or that over makeup tank. This is the procedure. And types of chillers. There are two types of chillers. As far as the device, as far as the source we are using to remove the heat from the high pressure hot gas, if you use water to remove the heat from the gas, it is called as a water cooled chiller. If you use a normal air, it is called as air cooled chiller. Normally both are in use. Most of the customers, they are using air cooled chiller as well as a water cooled chiller also. This will also will explain in separate. It requires minimum 1 hour to explain about this. And information about PAC. I told you this is a PAC, precision AC. This is very, very important. Normally, this AC is being used in server room, data center, hub room, labs. And the difference between this normal AC and this AC. This AC, of course, it has four elements. That is, all these four elements, compressor, condenser, expansion, and of course, evaporator. Apart from this, it has additional two parts, two machines, two devices, that is humidifier and dehumidifier, which controls the humidity as per its requirement. It's very, very important. Of course, controlling temperature is one, and the controlling the humidity also. This is very precise. That is why it's called as precision AC. As you know that in server room, data center, hub rooms, the electronic components in the motherboards of these devices, these are moisture sensitive devices. You have to control the moisture, water contents in that air. Normally this humidity, the level of the humidity is being maintained in between 40 to 60 RH, relative humidity. It should be 50 plus or minus 10 RH. 50 minus 10 is 40, 50 plus 10 is 60. It should be controlled. If there is any variation in this humidity, above 60 RH and below 40 RH, this humidifier and dehumidifier will work and it controls the humidity. This is the additional parts of this precision AC. And one more important, the air ducts are, you can see these air ducts on the floor, not on the ceiling. This is one main difference between normal AC to this PAC. If you find air ducts are fixed on the floor, you can say without seeing that, you can say it is a PAC. The purpose of using this is, in case if the humidity and dehumidifier and dehumidifier fails to function, in case the moisture enters inside, since the moisture has to, the air has to supply from the ground level, this moisture little bit of weight, and due to the gravitational force, it retains at the bottom of it, and only the air gets circulated. There also, it has been taken care. And the next, here are some photos. You can see this air-cooled chiller, it will be like this, and water-cooled chiller. And here you can make out this. These are the fans, which removes the heat from the gas in the condenser. This is air-cooled chiller. And remaining your compressor and evaporator and everything will be inside. And here also you can see this, the compressor and evaporator. This is the condenser where that water is being circulated, cold water enter inside, and this gas which is being circulated inside, that removes the heat from that, water becomes hot and goes back to that cooling tower, and again it gets cooled and circulates like this. And this is at AHO, what I told about. This is the higher capacity three-phase induction motor which is connected to the fan of this blower, which runs at the speed of 1500 RPM. And when this AHO is in running condition, door should not be kept open. Don't try to open the door because the pressure of the air will be such an high, even to that extent, even it can suck you also inside. And common air conditioning problems. What are the normal problems, common problems? Which is, I am talking about the common area outside, not inside the building. Refrigerant leak, if that R134 gas leaks due to the leakage, if there is any leakage, since it has, it consists so many pipes and so many connections, so many joints, if there is any slight leakages in these joints, the gas which comes out, so then in the gas, level of the gas, the pressure of the gas goes down, you will not get that cooling effect. This is normally we face this. And you see that is how the symptom of this, you can easily make out of this. If you see the formation of ice and water, that is because of this. So that is a symptom. When you complain to your vendor that ice is forming and water is leaking, immediately you will come and check all these connections. So they will tighten all these connection joints. He knows that some air gas is being leaked. And the next one, choking of air conditioning filters. These AHO filters are very, very important. I told you, when it sucks fresh air from the outside, it has to filter the contaminations, that is particular matters from the air, and it has to supply clean, filtered air inside. And these filters should be cleaned regularly, once in a week. So as per that weekly PPM, you have to prepare, you have to schedule the weekly PPM, and as per that, you have to clean it regularly. And a damaged ceiling and the insulating air ducts. And the air ducts, you see that the insulating material is used to avoid the heat losses, so that a particular shift in charge is air conditioner, what is AC technician and supervisors, and this is a team, you have to observe all these things. If there is any problems like this, these problems should be highlighted to the concerned person, and they should get it solved immediately. And electrical control failures, since you are using starters, as I said, this AHO motor is very high capacity three phase induction motor. You cannot use ordinary direct on resistor to control this. You have to use push, that is star delta starter. In case if this star delta starter fails to function, then your blower will not function. When the blower will not function, so that fresh air will not go inside the building, even though the entire air condition, entire chiller is in working condition, in good healthy condition. So this is very, very important. You have to ensure all these things in day-to-day operations. You have to take care. And there is a condensed water leaks. In actually, this is condensate water leaks. It comes in water cooled chillers. You have to crash check, and you have to identify where this water is getting leaked, and we have to arrest it immediately. We have to solve it. And a loss of air conditioning refrigerant charge. This is what leakage of refrigerant. If you maintain these things, all these things, if you avoid all this, if you control all these problems, the gas never gets consumed anyway. And your entire machine, entire system will work as per your requirement. And it fulfills your requirement. You can satisfy the customer and the employees their requirement also. You can solve their problems very easily. So this is about chillers. And if you have any concerns, if you have any doubts and questions, feel free to call me. Thank you. Thank you.